One of the trickiest problems in creating a litigation funding agreement pertains to the risk of waiving legal privileges that arises from introducing a third party to the lawyer-client relationship. It has often been noted that the doctrine of common interest privilege can be invoked to reduce or eliminate the risk of waiver. While this is correct, funders and litigants must take care to assure that there is an adequate basis for invoking the common interest privilege. The risk of waiver arises because a prospective third-party funder must perform due diligence before committing to invest in a case. The funder needs substantial information about the legal theories that the litigant will invoke and about the evidentiary basis for those claims. This information almost always comes from the litigant's counsel, who coordinates with the prospective funder in the interests of the client. In making this coordination, the lawyer must be careful about sharing client confidences or legal opinions, lest there be a waiver of the attorney-client or work product privileges. This is where the common interest privilege comes in. The common interest privilege, which is also known as the joint defense privilege, is an extension of attorney-client privilege that protects the compelled disclosure of communications between two or more parties and/or their respective counsel when the parties share a common legal interest. It permits a client to disclose information to his or her attorney in the presence of other parties and their counsel without waiving the attorney-client privilege, as long as all of the parties share such a common legal interest. In the context of litigation funding, the challenge of invoking the common interest privilege is a matter of timing. The rules governing the privilege make it clear that the parties must share an actual interest, not a prospective one, when they share confidential or privileged information. When a litigant shares information about its case with a prospective funder, the parties have only a potential common interest, not an actual one. Arguably, the actual common interest would not be created until the funder has an enforceable contract right to share in the litigant's recovery. At the due diligence phase, such a right does not yet exist. Thus, in order to rely on the common interest privilege with respect to the due diligence phase of litigation funding, the litigant and the prospective funder must create an actual common interest, even before they have entered an agreement that creates a shared legal interest in the litigant's claim. In the next post, we will examine some case law that has explored the common interest privilege in the litigation finance context, and we will draw some conclusions from that case law, which can guide litigants and funders in the due diligence process.